Hello and welcome to the Peter H channel, hopefully again. Today I wanted to use my old scanner, which is a printer scanner combi, and I wanted to scan some old 35mm photo prints. Some of you will know what these are and some people won't know what these are, but if you ever have an old photograph that you want to scan into your computer and or a laptop, I'm going to scan it into a laptop today. There are one or two issues that I think you might be helped out with this video. So the most important piece of equipment with this Hewlett-Packard, and it's not the software. I thought the software would be the issue, but you need this. It's a USB on one end, and it's a special Hewlett-Packard cable connection on the other end, at least I think it is. Well, if you haven't got that, you might be a bit stuck. And then of course you need your laptop and you need the scanner or printer scanner combi, as in this one. Like, this is an old all-in-one, so there are several all-in-ones, so hopefully yours will be the same. I've turned it on, and so I suppose the first thing to do will be to put the USB in the USB hole, which connects the printer scanner combi to the PC or laptop. Okay, so opening the scanner up there, put the first print in there upside down, and just butt it up against the thing. Close the lid. And this is where you have to go to the PC. The scanner doesn't actually do anything. Find your cursor there. The old cursor. Now you have to go into the settings there. And I think you go to devices. Now I haven't done this for a while. And go to printers and scanners. Now it's detected the HP 2100 series, so we'll press that. And here is where it gets a bit odd. You have to press manage, and it says printer stable, printer status idle. But if you press it here, you then get a separate box for the scanner. It's quite odd, because I mean, it took me ages to find that. Now when you press that, you have the option to open the scanner, and this is where the Windows 10 will operate the scanner for you without any sort of company software from whoever makes your printer scanner. In this case, I think it's HP. Anyway, I've already chosen JPEG there. See what else you could have had. Well, you could have had several different types of file there. But anyway, so let's just get right on in and scan that without a preview. So taking you to the scanner, it's working. I've actually got it on a very high DPI. Well, the highest it will go, actually. If I press show more, it might actually show me what I actually put it onto. No, it's not going to do it while it's scanning. Okay. We could twiddle our thumbs, I suppose. Actually, for you, this is just going to be a moment, because I'm going to cut this bit out. Alright, so it's beginning to put the scanner back to its default setting. It's now processing, obviously. Hopefully. Alright, so if I just press show more, I will just have a quick look. Yeah, I had it on 1200 DPI, which is the slowest kind of thing. Anyway, so now if we go to view, there is my little picture. Now it don't look like much at the moment, obviously, It looks too small, but you can edit this from here, which I'm not sure it's in the, well, we'll put crop and rotate, and I don't know how to do it. Shit. Now how the hell do you do that then? Oh, I think it'd be easier if I weren't holding the little camera. Right, well, well, you get the idea anyway. So that's, and that's how it works, you know. It's there isn't any need for any other sort of software. We'll have that actually, and that's scanned the original photograph into the PC now, and from there on it can go to wherever you'd like it to go. So thank you for watching. Check out my playlists if you want to get, if you want to check out my playlists, that would be nice for me. Would it be nice for me? I don't know. Thanks for watching.